Hey guys, Jay here, welcome to EonsOfBattle.com. Today I'd like to show you how I create my own custom bits. Today I'll be making a copy of this sword that I cut out of some old sprue for my Black Templars. So the first thing I did was I created myself a mold box using some old Legos. I used some flat pieces to make the bed, and then I'm building up the sides with some blocks. Now this is going to help to cut down on the amount of instant mold I'm going to be using, or oyumaru, and it is also going to help get sharper edges and lines. And then I'm going to create a push block to help push down the different layers of oyumaru. So I'm again using some flat blocks and then some bricks. And this is going to be used to press the oyumaru into the mold. So the first thing I did was to prepare my oyumaru. I poured in 2 cups of water into a pan. There's nothing particularly special about the 2 cups. Just make sure that you have enough water to saturate the oyumaru pieces. And once the water is warm, but not boiling, you can put in your sticks of instant mold. And then just make sure that you poke them around. Try to keep them off of the edges, because if the water gets too hot. And then once it is pliable, then you can begin your molds. So I took one little piece and I squished it down into my molds. So this is going to be the first half of the two-part mold. So then I began splashing on a little bit of the hot water to keep it pliable. And then I kept doing this until right before I was ready to put in my sword bit. So I took the sword and I squished it down just a little bit. Then I poked a few holes, which is going to fill in when I do the top half of the mold, and it's going to make the two halves fit together very easily. I then fixed it up here and there with my pencil, just poking it down. Now I used the point of a mechanical pencil as a pour funnel. And so then I popped it in the fridge, and then once it was sufficiently set, I then did the same steps to do the other half. Now one thing to note is that once you push down your push block, you're going to want to leave it there while the second half dries, because if you pull it out immediately, you could end up deforming the top mold a little bit. So here it is, all done. I'm going to peel the two halves apart, and there's the original sword. I then cut off the top bit to give myself a spot to pour from. As you can see, I can pour my resin right down the tunnel made by the mechanical pencil, and here is a finished cast. I used some Legos to help hold it in place. Now, in terms of casting material, I'm using alumilite resin, a two-part resin, but any slow-acting resin should work. Even a fast-acting resin will probably do pretty well, although it will damage the mold a little bit because oyumaru is activated by temperature. You could probably even use green stuff, but definitely a pourer would be better. I hope you enjoyed this video. As always, if you'd like to see more, you can visit us at our website at EonsOfBattle.com. If you have any other ideas or techniques you'd like to see us do, please leave in the comments below. Thanks for watching.